So I'm back. The game crashed. We replayed the battle. We lost again, but our infantry army had mostly infantry. It did a lot better this time, but it still lost. But it killed about 30% of the army instead of like 8%. Anyway, they did a good job for an infantry army, but they were defeated. So the garrison at Brest, they emptied Brest to move to the Eastern Front, and they are already defeated. We only left the troops that were needed in order to defend Wars and keep order. Alright. Merge the units here. We still have Gottfried Galen alive. And five other infantry units are moving there. Alright. To the front outside of Riga has collapsed, and now we need to defend Riga if they are about to invade here. We lost Oscar Battle in the battle. General will lead the big infantry army. Yeah. Forgot that we are not allied to Romania. They broke our alliance. We are not allied to Hungary either. We need to come allied again. Alright, let's move the diplomat towards Romania. And Hungary.
Click on the listed offer and demand items to create.
Show me how. Left click on an item. Of course, we want the updated map information.
Very generous treaty proposal.
And alliance military access. We will have military access as well. So we're allied to Hungary again. They had mostly infantry in this army that attacked. Alliance announced the Third Reich in Hungary, right. Don't we have more diplomats? I need to check the agents. We have Felix von Katchler outside of Finland. Finland is still under siege, so I can't speak to them. We have the diplomat moving towards Bulgaria there, and we had one talk to the Hungarians. Right. We have the French state Vichy, let's talk to them, or speak to them. Show me how, we want their map information as well. We will give them ours. And that's it. That's all we want from you, as we are already allied. Now we have the Vichy French map information. Zoom in on the minimap, we can see that they have areas in Europe here. Then they have areas in Africa. You can see the Americans there, Italians, Spanish, and the Vichy French. They have an island here too. The British have this area. Alright. We've spoken to all our neighbors. We even have the map information of Turkey. And British and French here. French are holding Aleppo. And Damascus is held by the British. Alright. So we are moving troops here. General Walter Graf here with a good army. Just needs a few more units to be a complete mechanized army. mostly with half of the tanks being Panzer 1s and the other half Panzer 4s, right? Didn't we have another great army here somewhere? Yeah, this army. Under Theodore Model. Less tanks, only the worst types, but we have lots of planes. And an anti-aircraft truck, so... Alright! Next turn. Yeah, they did besiege Riga. With one great army. They have another army moving through the rebel territory there. Towards... either they want to attack Brest or Warsaw. I see. Brest had revolted and so did this area. Minsk. They need to take those two areas. I think they have already taken Minsk now. And Brest. To be sure, we will send out one unit of infantry. Ah, they've crushed the rebels. So now Warsaw is threatened by the Soviet Union as well. They have two fronts. They managed to defeat the rebels. All their armies. And they are besieging Riga. Alexander Petrov is. So we have Gottfried Gehlen inside. The remnants of this army. The infantry army has reinforced the city. Four units of riflemen, one remnant of SLT infantry. Right, so they lack four units. We have some planes here. I move them to the infantry army. It's now reinforced with Stuka bombers. Two units of Stukas. And one unit of Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. We have air superiority at least. And another Stuka bomber plane will now move to Warsaw. As it's under threat. So this army will move towards the eastern front. I changed my mind, this Stuka unit will also move there. So you wasted two of the units defending Riga there. You have no planes in Stettin, no unit in Berlin. Nothing to move there. This army will continue towards Warsaw. So we have a new front there now against the Soviet. Prague could use... could move another unit maybe. So we have lots of infantry here. I will move the SLT infantry to that army. A full army there. Under Taylor model, mostly mechanized. We'll lack two units here. If the planes survive the battle, they will join. And in the army of Walter Graf. Faction destroyed! Finland has been defeated! So the Soviet Union have taken Finnish capital. Helsinki. It's time to get some more knowledge of their map.
Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is likely to be accepted.
Right. The updated map, as far as the Soviet Union is concerned. In the east, they have borders with the Turks. And they own all of this. Taken those two areas, as I suspected. They've taken Finland. Finland is defeated and occupied by the Soviet Union. End of turn report. We are now plus 779. That's good. Construction report. In München we have a civil headquarters. In Riga we have a small tank factory. And in Belgrade we have a cobblestone road. Recruitment report. We have some new troops in different cities. That's good. And diplomatic information. The following factions have declared that they are allies. The People's Republic of China and the United Soviet Socialist Republics. So Communist China and the Soviet Union are allies. The following factions have declared a ceasefire. People's Republic of China and Chinese Republic. And India and Portugal, alright. So our fleet here could move back. We will let them attack. So we have a strong army moving here. Another strong army here. Rommel will now enter Greece here. Can't move any further this time. Let's move the U-boat fleet to the port of Athens. Can't move the army this turn. We will move this army towards Athens and move the riflemen into this army and move something better out of it. Scout snipers. And some assault infantry there. Don't want to use this army as it is now. We need to combine the best of Rommel's army with the best of this army, the best of Gunther Alterbrung's army, and then we will have the worst units be their serve. Updated map information would be good.
A balanced or very generous treaty proposal.
And attack. You already have that, alright. Forgot the most important thing. An alliance. Alright, we're allied again. Alliance announced, the Third Reich in Romania. Here we have a Spanish state diplomat. Let's move this diplomat to Turkey.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create.
Show me how.
Left click on an item in the proposal to remove.
Map information.
A generous treaty proposal is likely to be accepted.
We won't give them Athens yet. We need to move our troops out of the region first. So that's it. The Soviet Union will send more troops our way. Yeah, if I don't attack now, I want to see something. Yeah, we have both armies. I prefer it if they attack, to be honest. Right, we need to build. Berlin, we are still building the big park. In Riga, we could actually. Yeah, I think in Riga we are. Fortunately, we will probably need to destroy things here. We can build panzers there. I don't trust that we will survive though. Let's destroy tank factory, the academy, and the port. We'll also destroy the mortar training grounds, medium concern. Trader, throw everything there. So I think the Soviets will take it, the city, the town. So we just set that that town back. Athens, well, it will be taken by our by a neutral faction. Yeah, let's just not sure here. Let's build a. I don't think we will build anything there. In Belgrade. Yeah, we could use a small tank factory. Warsaw, we are already building something. We're done. Let's go to Berlin and the recruitment. We're still constructing some Stuka bombers there. Oslo will get another unit of assault infantry. Amsterdam will get a unit of Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. In Brussels, we are going to get some Stuka bombers. Paris, we will get some more Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. Here in Rouen we need some fighter planes as well, as we already have some Stukas. Alright, and here we will get another unit of Stuka bombers. Alright. Some scout snipers in Zagreb. Assault infantry in Vienna. And assault infantry in Copenhagen. We're done with recruitment. Now let's take a look at agents. Felix von Katschler. He can stay there in case we want to have diplomatic relations with Soviets later. We have one diplomat outside of Istanbul, that's good. Ready to talk to Turkey. Alright, and then we have Alfred von Katschler in Austria. Let's move him towards the Portuguese. We have a new spy. Let's move the spy towards the front with the Soviet Union. So we have a female spy here. There's nothing we can do this time. Move these armies. We have revolts in Zagreb. Let's move some more infantry there. That's all I dare moving. Alright, next turn. Romanians are attacking the Hungarians. Our ally has attacked our other ally. Rioting in Zagreb. They did almost revolt. Not good. Let's move one of the planes there. Hopefully we will be able to stop the revolt. We need a general there. Let's move a general to Zagreb as well. Hopefully that will help with the unrest. This army is now moving up. Another army outside of Riga. Move the planes. The town isn't that important anymore, we remove the structures. So we have full army here now. With a lot of planes. The rest of the units here will defend, help defend Riga. This army will go to Warsaw. We don't need the assault infantry anymore. Let's move the planes out. Another army outside of Warsaw. Both of the fronts are being strengthened. War declared on ally Romania on Hungary. Yeah, I saw that. I do support Hungary because they didn't betray me previously. Well, Romania did. Right, so they have an arm here, riflemen, cavalry. All right, Rommel's army will now be merged here. We need to move out at least one unit. Move out the infantry. Don't need riflemen. Ah, we could just move out one of them. Let's do that. Now we will move the best units to Rommel's army. Rest will be moved out. Ah, we don't have room for that. Let's move the two SS units to this army. Rommel is the tank commander. He will get the tanks. snipers, assault rifle. Well, this army could use some Stokes mortars. I think they will get the assault infantry. Ah, I moved it to the wrong army. This is Roman's army. Alright, I saw wrong. Alright, let's move the riflemen here. Tanks will be moved to Roman, of course. All the riflemen will be moved to Gunther Adelbung. Africa Corps units will be remaining in Rommel's army. They are following with him. Let's move some BMW motorcycles to Rommel's army. The other two could be in Gunther Alderbung's army. And we already have some. I think we'll move some planes. One of the Stokes mortars will be in Alterbung's army. Actually, both of them could be in that army. And we move the pack 40s to Roma. I don't like the look of that. Let's move them in order. Alright. And one of the snipers could be moved. SS could be moved. Rommel didn't like the SS that much because he was honorable. Alright, and we will move the planes. And yeah. Rommel's army. Actually, the snipers could be moved as well. Get another BMW motorcycle here. Yeah, they could keep one BMW motorcycle. Maybe they should keep. One plane as well. Maybe we could get the BMW motorcycles. They get one plane. So, Erwin Rommel should leave his new army. A really strong army there. BMW motorcycles, Messerschmitt 109 planes, the unique North Africa Assault Corps, 2 Pack 40 artillery units, some Panzer 4s, mostly Panzer 1s. Right, and his own bodyguard of tigers. It hasn't been in battle yet. Now, let's take a look at this force here. Athens, we had planes. So they get the Stukas, of course. And we had some snipers. We'll move the riflemen into the city. The yeah, they will get the snipers. And the assault infantry. So the reinforcements will only be riflemen, hopefully. The SS here, they have snipers, they have assault infantry. Alright, no riflemen left. Here we have two units of assault infantry. Otherwise they have only riflemen. Alright. Can't replace them with anything, alright. Move this army to towards the eastern front. So that army has moved as well. Now let's talk to the Turk there. Speak to the Turks in case anything has changed on the map. We need the new information, but we are going to give them Athens, capital of Greece. Alright, done. So that was done there. Now let's move the U-boat fleet back towards the Atlantic. Ah, we have a transport ship here too. Let's move it too. We are currently in control of 18 regions. So we have lost at least 10 regions since we started. We had 28 from the beginning, or 27. So at least 9 or 10 regions have been lost, either to the Soviet Union or we have given them away to the Italians and Turkey, because we couldn't hold them. We needed all the armies in the east. So Turkey has taken Greece, pretty much, without having to fight. We need to send a diplomat back to Romania to make them allied again.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal. Left click on an item in the proposal to remove.
Can't, because they are at war with our ally, right?
Treaty proposal is likely to be accepted.
End of turn report. We are plus 6817. Faction announcements, Ferdinand von Bock. Ferdinand von Bock. Yeah, Retinue expands. Let's see, some information there. Construction report, we have some medium park, some civil headquarters, asphalt roads, right. Recruitment report, we have new units in several cities. Ceasefire in effect, Thailand is no longer at war with the United States of America. Alliance in tatters, Romania, the Third Reich, yeah. So we have one great army under Erwin Rommel here. In Yugoslavia currently. And another good army, but mostly infantry. But better than riflemen at least. Elite infantry and some other stuff. And then a reserve army with just riflemen. Alright, they are moving through Yugoslavia currently. wait a second. Hungary did betray me. So I took their side over Romania. They took their side in the past. Should have taken Romania's side when I think about it. As Hungary did attack me, actually. Bulgaria is the one that was loyal. And Italy, yet. Alright. So we have Miklos Horthy, faction leader, inside of Novi Sad, one unit of assault infantry. Riflemen. Alright, they will probably be defeated and lose that area because they have their army here. It is. Anyway, our spy here, female spy, is ready to move. Let's move her. I can see some Hungarian armies here in Uskorod. We even have Messerschmitt 109 planes here. The full army in this road as well.
Kaiser? Mein Kaiser?
So I need to recruit stuff, I think, and build stuff. I don't think I have done this on this turn. So in Frankfurt we could build an aerodrome, civil headquarters and a large concern. Let's start with the civil headquarters, the civil building. Alright. Amsterdam, we'll get some civil headquarters as well. Brussels, could get a port in Brussels. Paris. Big park, I think. Rouen. We'll get a port. And Bordeaux, we could also get a port. In Riga. We won't build anything in Riga, unfortunately. It's under siege. In Warsaw. Could be under siege any moment. Should have the farms, I believe. So we will build it. I guess we will just do this. Alright, I'm surprised I didn't already have that. Build a small park in Warsaw. And we're done. Let's go back to Berlin and look at the recruitment instead. Alright. I need a Messerschmitt 109 fighter plane there. Here we could use Stuka bombers. Assault infantry in Oslo. In München, we use fighter planes. In Frankfurt, we will need a Stuka bombers. And in Amsterdam, we are already constructing stuff. Same in Brussels, and in Paris, in Rouen, in Bordeaux, in Riga. Yeah, it's fine. To recruit troops there. In Belgrade, could use some Messerschmitt 109 planes. And in Warsaw, we could also use some planes. Let's construct some Stuka bombers there. Some assault infantry in Vienna. Prague, we could also use some fighter planes. In Stettin, we will construct some Stuka fighters, that means Stuka bombers. Assault the infantry in Copenhagen. And we're back in Berlin. Now we just need to move some troops. Construction complete, the farms, yes. Alright, we're done here. So we have some infantry there. Nothing to move out. Here we have some Stuka bombers there needed in case we are attacked, but I think we moved them to Warsaw. Berlin. Let's move troops to Warsaw.
Ja, Kaiser. Unsere heutige Reise ist beendet, Kaiser.
So Messmith, we could move them to München for now.
Ja, mein Kaiser.
Some Stokes mortars, ja, move them towards the front. Frankfurt. Let's move some troops to München there. Leave some stuff in Amsterdam. Maybe we don't need a plane in Amsterdam. Move them towards the front. We had some planes, move them to München. Too many planes in Rowan. Let's move some planes to München. Yeah, and that's it. We have the fleet here as well. We can move it to Port of Berlin. And next turn, Soviets are attacking Riga. Only with two armies. We have Alexander Ivanov with his army, of course, that defeated us two times already. And then we have Boris Ivanov and Murad Ivanov with more starting troops. Let's save the game. We didn't get any backup from our army outside. That wasn't good. That means we are fucked. Still had one unit of Stuka bombers here. We'll see how long it will hold. They have a lot of tanks. They also have planes here. Alright. Let's play the battle. I'm sure it will crash after, but let's play it. Crash now. Alright, this is it for now. See ya soon. Alright, I'm back. The game will lag now because I'm actually creating part 3 of my Let's Play while also playing. So if the game will lag or something, I will have to redo this because I don't want to have a laggy video. But we will play now because I couldn't wait. It takes forever to create videos. You know, I record and then I use a program to create the video, make it smaller, but it takes forever to process. Alright, start deployment. We are defending. I thought we were supposed to defend the city here. City of Riga. Instead we seem to have our units outside. Maybe it's the army outside of... Yeah, it's the army outside of the city that is attacked, I see. They didn't get help from the army inside. I think it's the army outside because I don't see a city here. And I kind of remember the army outside being comprised of infantry and one unit of Stuka bombers because I moved the other two. Alright, let's put them in loose formation, group, and then we will place them under AI control. Start the battle. So the reinforcing army is under attack. We will attack because we need to try and destroy as many as possible of their troops. They have two huge armies here. Yeah, it did lag, unfortunately. But the other army is entering, so it could be because of that. We'll see. It should stop when this army has entered. So we have lots of infantry here, 5 units of infantry. They will all be steamrolled by the tanks sooner or later. And we have the Stuka bombers, the only good unit in this force. Kind of wasted it here. So the tanks are moving. Our troops there. Wonder if we will be able to take them out. Take out some of their tanks, or if we be shot down from the skies before that could happen. They already shot down one of the planes. We have started to bomb their tanks there. We took out one of the tanks. Maybe one hit and they are out. That's the good thing about the bombers. Kill tanks in one hit. Infantry are broken too, as expected. Are they still entering here? Seem to be inside. I don't like that it lagged. They won't replay this battle because it's an uninteresting battle with just a few troops. We've already lost the planes and the infantry, only 9 left that are still not broken. The rest are broken, I see. Yeah, it lagged a lot. I'm not sure they have the entire army inside. However, I will not play another battle as long as we are creating that movie. As I believe that's why it lagged. 30, we are too covered to take part. Now they are in a hurry so they can share the spoils. Adolf Hitler on the Italian declaration of war on France and Great Britain. June 10, 1940. Yeah, the Italians, they declared war when Hitler had already won the battle in the East, and they saw an opportunity to share in the spoils of France. Alright. Alright, so the Soviet Union took out the reinforcing army. We merged the units here. Once they managed to flee. End of turn report. We are minus 11,050. That's not good. Faction announcements. New family member Arthur Gillen. And marriage celebrations. Paul von Manstein, alright. ceasefire in effect. Italian Empire and the United Soviet Socialist Republics. Alright, the Soviet Union has a ceasefire with the Italian Empire. They have no border against them anymore. We're taking Kharkov. So the closest region to Italy is over here. We need to go through Romania and Hungary first to get there. We have a Turk army here now. Riflemen, assault infantry, cavalry. Alright, we will move some troops too. This area. Erwin Rommel will move towards Zagreb there on his way to the Eastern Front. Infantry. Better army of infantry will move here too. This army could reinforce. Force Belgrade here. Actually, we'll move the assault infantry into the area of Zagreb here. Move a rifleman unit into Belgrade. Use one plane unit there. It's defense. So we are defending Belgrade there. It's a little unfair for Bulgaria there. Area. All right.
Left click on the list of offer and demand items to create a
map information. Change my mind. It will give Bulgaria capital of Yugoslavia, which is Belgrade, and the reason is because we need the troops moved. They could use another region. They got some troops there as well. Riflemen, the whole bunch, I believe. We needed that to counter Hungary and Romania. They also have three regions. So Yugoslavia is now under Bulgaria's control. Two armies here. I don't like that they have a plane there. Move the plane to the other army. Another Stuka unit. Assault infantry to this arm here. Made up entirely of infantry.
Mein Kaiser? Ja, mein Kaiser. Verlassen die Armee, Kaiser!
this unit the next time then. Let's move a rifle unit back to that army. Alright. Could use some updated information about their map.
Left click on the listed offer.
They get updated information about our map.
Left click
well.
On an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is likely to be accepted.
Alright. So the Soviet Union is huge now. Conquer all the Finnish areas too. Alright. Some tanks there. Just got beaten. So we have increased force there. Do we have anything we can move here? Stokes mortar maybe. They have 7 fighter planes and 2 Stukas. Could use another Stuka for sure. And aircraft trucks. Use the Stuka instead. And probably a jeep bodyguard. Yeah, I think we could use the motorcycle inside of the city and then move out the planes instead. Send this army against the army here. Look, they have even more armies there. So we have 2 battles at least to fight here. 1 battle against Dmitry Petrov here and his army. We also have Ivan Petrov here. So Warsaw has almost been emptied. Spy here, let's send her up here. Another great army here. We have Leonid Petrov here. No, Georgi Ivanov, he also has Stalin's portrait. Alright. Grigory Ivanov, Alexander Petro, and Ivan Konev. Captain Ivan, alright. Let's let the spies stand there for now. I have one battle to fight there. Send some planes to Warsaw. Vienna, we have a lot of infantry. Can't move them. Move some infantry to Warsaw. From Prague and from Stettin. Vichy France is also a threat still. There are 4 units there. Here we have quite a force. Combine the assault infantry troops there. Need to send at least one unit of riflemen to Oslo. Keep 3 in Copenhagen. Dangerous, we need to take another route, otherwise the British might attack us. I forgot about that. Alright. We have some fleets here. The Americans have taken Tunis from the Italians. They aren't strong enough to keep the areas that I gave them. Hungary. Don't need to speak to them right now. We have Zagreb here. Couldn't reach Italy this time. Might give them Zagreb so they get a border. They can have a united country. This area should probably belong to them, I don't know. Makes sense. Then we can move this army too. Towards the east. look at their numbers. We have a lot of armies and a lot of regions. Let's take a look at our agents. All right, let's look at our agents. Diplomats, we have one outside of Helsinki. We have one close to Tirana there. Can't move anymore. We have one the border of Vichy, France, and we have the spy there. All right. Then it's this one we will need to move towards Italy. Yeah, we'll do that. Show me how. Map information. A balance and of very generous region is likely to be accepted. We will give them Zagreb. So Italians got Zagreb for free. They have a united country there. They also got some good garrisons, scout snipers and stuff. We are still in their territory. Let's move to Vienna with this force. Can move out the assault infantry there. We'll switch them with, we'll replace those units, the riflemen with better units here. Snipers and assault infantry. Now they only have riflemen left, alright. This force here. They'll also march towards the eastern front. Lots of infantry armies, unfortunately. We had one assault infantry there. That wasn't good. Can't move now too. So Italy is still in control of these areas, Mogadishu and Addis Ababa. Let's see. Addis Ababa. Alright, Addis Ababa. So we have some armies too. Going towards the east. Unfortunately, most of them are infantry. French state, which diplomat there. build some buildings. Ah, we missed the settlement here. Riga, but it's under siege, so that's fine. We have nothing to build. Now let's look at the recruitment. So we are constructing some fighters, Messerschmitt 109 fighters in Berlin. Oslo, we could get another assault infantry unit. Seeing as how the face there was blue. Alright, in Amsterdam we will get some Stuka bombers. In Brussels we'll also get some planes. We'll get some fighters. In Paris we'll get some Stukas. And in Rouen I will also construct some Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. In Bordeaux could use some fighter planes as well. And some assault infantry in Vienna. Alright, and that's it. I want to know more about the Soviet front here. Let's move the spy forward. So Soviet Union has some troops here. They will strike towards Warsaw soon. Another general with Stalin's portrait. There is Leonid Petrov. Alright. So we need to fight at least one battle. Equal here. So if we check the garrisons here, we have quite forces there. Let's move one of the Stuka planes. Fighters could move as well. One of the fighters could move here too. Some artillery. AMX 105 AM artillery. Then they have a lore 155-51. Alright. And some infantry, snipers and riflemen. This plane to Stettin. Now we can't do much more than start the battle. So we have Theodore Model here. And he has a Jeep bodyguard. Huge arm of planes. Rifleman unit. And we have Gerd von Rundstedt. That might be an actual historical general, I'm not sure. Well, this isn't one, I believe. We have Walter Graf here too. An enemy force, they have 3 tanks. Can't move all the way to Riga. That means we will have to use the SS infantry to attack that unit. Shit, they have 2 armies. We didn't get the backup I wanted. Still have 2 armies. That sucked. We let them attack them, but we will attack with this army here. The rifleman unit. So they have some starting armies here. And generals Nikolai Petro. Ivan Petro and Dmitry Petro. Alright. Save the game. And I will exit here. Alright. Hello, Victor Nygren here. I'm back and playing Total War 1942, a mod for Rome Total War Barbarian Invasion. Alright, it will work with the original as well, but not Alexander, because it uses unique features from the Barbarian Invasion in order to have ship battles in custom battles and historical battles. Alright, when loading a save game, always click on this symbol. It will activate the script. So now it's active, and we are going to jump straight into a battle. The battle outside of Brest here. Yeah, the border between Brest and Riga. Right. And Brest is held by the Soviet Union now, while Riga is still controlled by us, but we are under siege. Alright, let's start the battle. They have an army of only tanks and some rifleman bodyguards. Our losses have reached an intolerable level. The enemy air force played a decisive role in inflicting these high losses. Grand Admiral Karl Dönitz, Commander-in-Chief of the German Navy, 24th May 1943. Start deployment. I think about it. Let's let these guys just stand here and be in guard mode. So we have some reinforcements arriving. So the Soviet army, mostly made up of T-34 tanks, so it's comprised of starting armies. It has like 3 generals bodyguards of riflemen, otherwise it's like 15 or something, maybe more, like 18. I believe it's 17 T-34 tanks and 3 units of riflemen. Alright. Our great air force has arrived. Our mechanized army is comprised mostly of air force planes. The Luftwaffe. Alright. Because 11 units were planes, and then we had 4 units of Panzer I tanks. They are inferior to their T-34 medium tanks, because the Panzer I's are light, lightly armored and have light projectiles. Alright, and then we had 2 MC motorcycles, BMW motorcycles, and 1 unit of snipers, and the bodyguard with his jeep. So the main strength of our army is that the great number of planes that I've constructed and moved to the east. We have, I believe, we have 4 or 5 units of Stuka bombers, Stuka tactical bombers, and then we have the rest of them being Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. So we have clear air superiority here. In real life they wouldn't be able to do anything, because they don't have anything that can hit planes. I mean, tanks can't fire at planes, and infantry can't fire at planes, but in this game they can, so we will lose a few planes. However, planes are still the best units in the mod, so we will win this battle. Enemy general fallen, Nikolai Petrov is dead. Unit routes. We already had a Stuka bomber plane squadron run away from the battlefield. My Panzer I is here moving forward the field of battle. Infantry generals are routing. And my BMW motorcycle is here. Look at the fire from the fighter planes. The Soviets are being crushed from the fighter planes' fire. Alright. Continue battle. Dmitry Petrov also died in the battle, and our infantry hasn't even been hurt in the battle. It's intact. 81 men. Enemy general fallen, Ivan Petrov died, and we won. So, our infantry killed 2 and lost 0, had 81 men. Theodor Model with the great army had 474 men and killed 836. That's because the planes are very, very effective, and men remaining 444, so they lost a few. And then Gerd von Rundstedt, a historical general, unlike Theodor, had 357 men. I believe he had an anti-aircraft truck and a lot of infantry and maybe a plane, I'm not sure. And he killed 0, so he wasn't involved in the battle, and he has all of his men left. I'd like to replace Theodor with Gerd von Rundstedt, and use Theodor as the general for the smaller army. Alright, enemy army led by Dmitry Petrov. There were 2 other generals there as well. They had 1083 men, mostly T-34 tanks, but also a lot of infantry. And all of they killed 30 of our troops, and I guess they were probably planes, most of them. And then they have 231 left. The detailed statistic here. Yeah. let's just hope it won't crash now when this is done loading. And I also hope we won't lose a lot of planes. We won the battle, man of the hour, earned after the battle. Can't move this army anymore. Shit. We lost all of those troops. That's bad. That's every time we use a mechanized army, we almost lose half of the units. And we merge it after the battle. Very, very odd. They are easily killed. Let's move the anti-aircraft trucks there. Motorcycles. Move. Theodore model. Theodore model has been moved to the other army, and we move Rundstedt to the main army. None of these can be moved. We will keep him where he is. Assault infantry could be moved to the bigger army. And the infantry units there. Actually, we move both generals to this army then. These planes can't be moved this time. Stoke mortars can't reach. But still try to move them there. Right. So we won the battle there. They have lots of armies here. Also, they have two armies here. See if we are backed up. No, we are not. That's not good. Shouldn't have moved out the SS infantry there. So we lost two of our Panzer I tanks. That's to be expected. We also lost some of our fighter planes. I believe we had four Stukas. Now we have two, so we lost half our Stukas. And then about the Messerschmitts, we probably had at least five planes were lost, and two of them were Stukas. We lost three Messerschmitt 109 units. So that's not good. All right. So we have some troops moving here. Mostly infantry. Elite force there under Erwin Rommel. You had a better force with some planes too. Would be good if we gave them some better stuff instead of just infantry. We have some planes on the move. Stokes mortars. Infantry. We need to make them more mechanized. If I click next turn now, I think they will attack Riga, and Riga won't be backed up by this force. So I may need to attack. Yeah, I will attack. This army has some Panzer 4s, 4 units of Panzer 4s and 4 units of Panzer 1s, that's pretty good. It also has 1 unit of BMW motorcycles and 6 units of Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes, 3 units of Stuka bombers. Stuka bombers, yes. They have a lot of tanks, infantry and even planes. That's Alexander Petrov, Alexander Ivanov, the guy who defeated our two other armies in the past, the Nordic Division and the other infantry army. Alright. Start the battle. Our citizens can now rejoice that a momentous victory is in the making. Perhaps we will be forgiven if we claim we are about midway to our objective, Admiral Chester Nimitz, June 1942. Wait, start deployment. So we are in control of the entire army now. We have quite the air force. We have 4 units of Panzer 1s, but we also have 4 units of Panzer 4s now. They are equal in strength to their T-34s. So they still have the upper hand in tanks. I believe ours might be better or slightly worse, I'm not sure. But the planes are what matters here the most. We have the jeeps. Yeah, we have quite a force of Panzer IVs here now. Good. And some remaining Panzer Ones. And of course the BMW motorcycles. Alright, let's place the army under... Let's group the army and lose formation and place under AI control. I think the enemy will run away. We'll see what they will do. So we have ordered the units to attack. I'd like to see the statistics of these tanks. They're too far away. If we look at the statistics of the Panzer I, we can see that a Panzer I unit counts as soldiers 12, experience 1, melee attack 11, so when they drive over people they have 11 attack, and the missile attack is 17. They have 23 in total defense or armor. We look at the Panzer IV. They also have 12 in soldiers and 11 in melee, so they are the same in melee as the Panzer I. They have 23 in missile, that could be compared to 17 for the Panzer I. So they have 5 more in attack, and then they have 28 in defense or armor instead of 23. So they have 5 more in defense and 5 more in attack than the Panzer I. They also have the medium shell, which is a bigger projectile than the small shell that the Panzer I is using. Alright. I don't know about the T-34, but they also have the medium shell. Lancer 4. So the army is moving forward on the battlefield here. Like that we finally have something better than Panzer Ones. We still don't have enough of these tanks. And they didn't look bad this time around, because they are freshly arrived from Germany. Plane should reach the enemy first. The jeeps are also moving forward. Here we have the enemy, Soviet Union, with their tanks and infantry. Not the biggest force, this one. As well. Our Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes have arrived. As well as the motorcycles here. Good. We have reached the battlefield with our troops. Out one of my Panzer IVs there. Let's pause the battle. I'd like to find one of their tanks. We can look at their statistics. They had this probably lost a few soldiers, but it has 8 soldiers. So they have melee attack 12 and 22 missile attack and 25 defense. So the 12 melee, I believe we had 11, so they have better damage than our tanks when they drive over people or infantry. They have 22 missile and 25 defense. The Panzer IV has better defense, but has worse attack, 24 attack instead of 25, but has 29 defense instead of 25, I believe. How to click on it? Alright, 25 and 22. 24. We have better defense and better attack, actually. They had 22 attack and we had 24. They had 25 defense and we had 29, so that's good. But they have better melee when they drive over people. They had... No, they have the same. We have 12 and they had 12 too. We also have 11 here, so maybe the one with 12 is slightly... I guess he could have earned experience. He has experience 1. Well, the other one lacked experience, alright. And then the Panzer 1 are just one below when it comes to attack, but they have 17 missile and 23 defense. So the Panzer 1 has better defense than the T-34 tank. Two better in defense as T-34. Or wait a second. No, I'm wrong. It has worse defense. It has 23 defense and 17 attack. And this one has 22 attacks. It's better. And 25 defense. They have better defense than the Panzer One, but not that much. However, the Panzer IV is better than their tank. So, well, this tank is worse than their T-34 tank. We have the Panzer IV that is actually better. Both armor and projectile. So the riflemen are trying to fire at our fighting planes, fighter planes. The armies are quite stretched out. Here they are fighting some broken T-34 tanks that have seen battle in the past. Oh, here comes the Soviet Jack 9 planes. Face off against our Messerschmitt 109 planes there. Let's zoom in the map, by the way. So, Murad Ivanov died, the general of the Soviet Union. They have another army moving in here. With MS-1 tanks. Let's pause. I can't click on them right now. That tank is more in line with the Panzer I, I believe. Similar in stats to the Panzer I. Their most deadly unit is the plane, but we have lots of planes in this battle, so I don't really fear losing. What I do fear is that I might actually lose a lot of my planes when coming back to the map after battle.
Ein Feind des Reiches liegt tot zu unseren Füßen.
Need to click on the army. We are not. We are letting the AI control it, but we are still somehow in need of clicking on the enemy to make it active. All right. Let's attack the other army now. Panzers are moving forward here. The Panzer IVs and the Panzer Ones, even the Messerschmitts. And BMW motorcycles along the entire front. Planes are fighting each other, but they have too few planes to stand a chance here. As far as I can see. So we have clear air superiority here. One plane went down. I don't think it was theirs. They might take down some of our Stukas there. They had more than three planes. How is the land battle? Our Panzer IVs are moving up the hill here. Against their infantry. Messerschmitt got taken down there. some T-34s here still alive. Got taken down. This is statistics. 9% allies killed, 57% enemies killed. So this battle is a clear defeat for the Soviet Union. We really needed that. They have lots of armies still. We don't have that many armies. So we need to still limit their numbers down a bit. But we are sending reinforcements from Greece and Africa that are also soon to face off against their other armies. They are in the Brest territory. We had 4 or 5 armies there. Let's continue. Our Stukas dropping bombs. The fighter planes are firing their projectiles over half the map. Alright. The infantry is slaughtered. They are trying to leave the battlefield and flee. Look at the bombs here. We had a lot of Stuka bombers. Alright, we won the battle. Battle results. Clear victory. Your army, Walter Graf, had 461 men deployed, killed 1516 men. So you see how effective the planes are. Men remaining, 424. Alright, the enemy had one army under Boris Ivanov with 690 men. They only managed to kill 13. That's really bad. 60 remaining out of 690. Alexander Ivanov, the general who destroyed our Northern Legion and also the other army that came from Brest with mostly infantry and remnant mechanized units, he also were defeated. He had 929 men. He killed only 30, he had 35 left. Alright. We finally defeated that general. Alright. The Russian convoys are and always have been an unsound operation of this war. The Russian convoys are and always have been an unsound operation of this war. Rear Admiral L.H.K. Hamilton, September 1942. Ah, no crash, good. And we won. Big. But we lost a lot, probably, yeah. Almost half the army. So the SS will come back to the army. And then we had some troops inside of Riga. Some artillery. And planes that we will move out immediately. All the remnant stuff from earlier battles there. Don't need a unit of 8 riflemen, disband. So we got Fried Galen here as well. We merged the troops. Now and we actually managed to defeat the enemy. We need a new civil headquarter to get the public order back up, because it's horrible. They are almost about to revolt. We have a small Soviet force there, including the MS-1 tanks. They have 10 in melee, so they are one worse than the Panzer-1. They have only 13 missile attack, and the Panzer-1 have 17, so they are kind of bad. They have total defense 27, so they have better defense than the Panzer-1 at 23, and slightly worse defense than the Panzer-4, alright. So the MS-1s have better defense than the T-34s, but are worse in attack and such. One unit of Reich assault infantry, we don't need that. Disband. This guy. And that's it, we can't do anything more this turn. Riga is not well defended anymore, so the army might need to go back there next turn. Let's see if we can build anything. We are still constructing the big park in Berlin. I don't think we have anything to build. No, we didn't. Alright, and as for units, I think we have recruited everything too. Maybe in Riga, but I don't think we have any buildings that enable us to recruit anything. Maybe riflemen. I think there were nothing to do there. It's time to click next turn. We will take a look fast at our agents to see if we have anything we can move there. We won't move Felix von Katchler. We can't move Ferdinand Furbringer. Alfred von Katchler. So who is that? French state which? And we have Italy there. Let's talk to the French state again.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal.
Left click map information. Map information done. So we updated our map information with the Vichy French or Vichy France. They own areas in Africa and have an ISIL. More than that they don't have. We got the map information from the Soviet Union. So I guess the white areas here are Japan. Alright. The spy, we can't move her. I